the Texas 2 to about the 16-yard line. So, John Unitas, we expect to have our first question answered. Will it be Donnie Little or Rick McIver who starts at quarterback? That'll be the offensive line for Texas, Millard. We don't know whether it'll be Sheeran or Dawson at that guard, by the way, but we'll check it as we go along. There are always a couple of last-minute changes. Going out wide will be the leading receiver for Texas, number 13, Les Koning. Starting quarterback is Rick McIver. Getting to the outside and into the secondary is Darrell Clark, the Houston sophomore running back for the Longhorns, and a good gain on first down. North Carolina defensively. Starting Friesen, keep your eye on North Carolina's number 98, Lawrence Taylor, everybody's All-American. Carolina gets a first down up to the 30-yard line, and again it is Darrell Clark, brought down by Lee Schaffer, one of the four Carolina linebackers.
North Carolina finished the season, Ray, and is number 11 against the rushing teams throughout the season. Nationally ranked 11th so far. Texas has moved the football well on the first two plays against them on the run. I would think that we are going to have them continue to stay on the ground as much as possible as long as they can control the game.
McCloney, number 21, brought in the plays, lined up wide to the right. First down, Texas at the Longhorn 30. McIver to the pass. Almost picked off by Steve Streeter, who had an unusual accomplishment behind his name. He was twice all-conference, but at different positions. Once as a defensive back, once as a punter, and he made a perfectly timed play, the senior from Silver, North Carolina.
He's an outstanding punter and holds an average of 43.4 yards for the whole season. He does an outstanding job as well. Back in the defensive secondary, he has 11 interceptions over the four-year period that he's played.
Second down, 10, Texas at the Texas 30. McIver pitches back to the outside is Carl Robinson. Good gain, close to a first down, out to about the 38-yard line, about, or perhaps 3 yards shy, is sophomore Carl Robinson from Temple, Texas. Hit out of bounds by Tyrus Bratton, one of the two cornerbacks for North Carolina. Third down and a little bit less than three for a first down. Remember, those are the phone numbers to call. Do you want to see a playoff for the college championship? Yes, that's your number, 720-8105. First down, Mike Locke at the Texas 45-yard line. The Houston freshman has to be brought down by Bill Jackson out of the secondary. So the Longhorns, back-to-back first down. This one at the Texas 45-yard line. And bringing in the play this time is number 44, Carl Robinson. We have not as yet seen Jam Jones or Rodney Tate. Carolina's linebackers are Daniels, Schaffer, Nicholson, and Taylor. Second man, short gain, Carl Robinson. At the most, a yard. See who he ran into there, John.
Well, they're running pretty much of the time right at Lawrence Taylor, the number one linebacker, consensus All-American for the North Carolina Tar Heels. They don't seem to fear him at all, Ray. So far, they've done an outstanding job at the line of scrimmage.
The cornerbacks for Carolina, Greg Poole, 32, Tyrus Bratton, number 3. The deep men defensively are Streeter, 50, and Jackson, 28. Second down. There's a little delay. Oh, a fake! And a beautiful completion to Lawrence Sampleton, the tight end, and I was fooled completely.
He did a tremendous job, McIver, on the fake of the draw. Let's take a look at it from the end zone camera as we see McIver coming grab some center. There's the fake of the draw right there. Look downfield. There's the throw to Sampleton. So far this season, he's caught 20 out of 38, and for 20 passes for 381 yards and 3 TDs. An outstanding blocker on the line of scrimmage for the run as well.
Third and 2, Texas at the 47-yard line of Carolina. First quarter, no score. out of the I formation. And good strong running by the freshman, Mike Luck, number 26. Brought down by, among others, Darnell Thompson, number 76, along with Taylor and Nicholson. But it is another Texas first down. This is a very impressive offensive beginning for the Longhorns.
And again, you have to credit that offensive line for really moving in and blowing out the Carolina Tar Heels. They've been commanding the line of scrimmage, and that's where the ball game is played, right in the pits.
Wide to the right is Koenig, the leading receiver for Texas. In the slot to the right is McCloney. But here comes Mike Luck, and short game this time. Good job done by Donnell Thompson, the defensive left end.
Ray, thus far in our poll right now that is being taken in conjunction with AT&T, should there be a national playoff to determine a national college champion? There is a 50-cent charge which will be added to your phone bill. Thus far, 4,189 have voted yes, 294 have voted no.
Keep your eye on number 23, Rodney Tate, the junior. Begs Oklahoma. He's in the running back's position now for Texas. And this, however, is Mike Luck to the short side. Short of a first down at the 36-yard line of North Carolina.
The thing that has stopped the Texas Longhorns most of the season, Ray, has been the fact that they've had an awful lot of penalties. They've been penalized 366 more yards than their opponents have throughout the season. A lot of these penalties have come in crucial points during the ball game and have stopped an awful lot of their drives. We'll see if they have corrected that in the next few plays.
Now, on third and three, Texas goes with two tight ends. Sampleton is joined by Steve Hall. Third and two and a half, the tailback.
It was a good line search by the North Carolina Tar Heels. I don't believe he got the first down on that play.
The question now is, Texas in four down territory. Will the Longhorns go for a first down on fourth and about one at the 34 and a half yard line of North Carolina? Texas has held the ball for 5.5 minutes. We have no score. The Bluebonnet Bowl, the Astrodome in Houston. In with the play selection comes wide receiver number 13, Les Koenig, a senior from Houston. He replaces McCloney. They still go with two tight ends. Mike Luck is close to a first down. Was made by two of the linebackers, Darrell Nicholson and Lawrence Taylor, but close enough to call for a measurement in the vicinity of the 33-yard line of North Carolina.
Number 49, Bruce Hemphrey on the stop.
Thus far in our survey, Ray, we now show 14,637 voting for a college football playoff to determine a champion, and only 900 voting no.
Luck gets the first down by a narrow margin. At the North Carolina 33-yard line, exactly 9 minutes left to play first quarter. Texas took the opening kickoff, moving mainly on the ground, has moved to a first and 10 at the Carolina 33. Wide to the left, McCloney. The quarterback is Rick McIver. A lot of time, might be made a change. Overthrows McCloney around the 10-yard line. I thought there might have been a Carolina offside, but I think he was able to get back. Is that right?
I think he jumped back in time, Ray. And it might be interesting to note the contrasting styles with McIver and Donnie Little. Little is primarily a running type quarterback, who's actually the second leading ball carrier for Texas with 487 yards, where McIver certainly has a much stronger arm than Little, has played well so far, and he's played well when Donnie Little was not able to during the season. McIver can run the football if he has to, but he's primarily a pocket-type passer with a very strong rifle-type arm.
Into the lineup. Number 11, Kiki Walls. Uh-oh, here's Walls on the end around. Penalty flag down, however. If the penalty is against North Carolina, it's down behind the line. Let's see what our officials have. The play
Let's take a look at the play. We see the movement in the Texas line, and that's what really happens here. They can start too soon and have a penalty. This is what I talked about earlier, that these are the things that have been happening to the offensive team of Texas, killing drives by offside penalties and major penalties in the tight situations.
Second and 15 for Texas at the Carolina 38-yard line. McIver, good protection, penalty flag down. McCloney at the 25, at the 21. But remember, we have another penalty flag down. It probably is holding. The infraction occurred behind the line in the vicinity of the quarterback.
Again, the same things have happened to Texas all season long, stopping drives.
Vince Buckley, the retired Southwest Conference referee, who was with us at the Hall of Fame Bowl in Birmingham, is with us again tonight. So, Vince Buckley, our first chance to call you in.
Howard and Ray and Johnny, you'll note that this is a 15-yard penalty, which is holding. And this year, the rule has been changed to where if it's just illegal use of the hands, it's 5 yards. But in this case, it was a holding or illegal obstruction, and that cost them 15 yards.
So now, it is a second and 30 for Texas at the Longhorn 47-yard line instead of a first down at the Carolina 21. That was a costly penalty.
Again, the old penalty bugaboo for Texas.
Jim Harper, Jr. is our referee tonight, all of the officials from the Southeastern Conference. McIver, that's a screen pass. Mike Luck, good gain to the North Carolina 40-yard line. At that point, it will be third down and about 17. The other officials tonight, Pete Williams is the umpire, Robert Gaston, the linesman, Ed Dudley, Jr. is the line judge, Joe Delaney, Jr., the field judge, and Bobby Shelton, the back judge, and as we told you, all officials from the Southeastern Conference. For Texas, in this game that is scoreless, with 7.5 minutes left to play first quarter, third and 17. Wide to the right is McCloney, who caught that pass a moment ago that was called back. Big, big rush. McIver showing good speed. Almost intercepted at the Carolina 21-yard line by Tyrus Bratton. But big pressure on McIver, and the result, incomplete pass.
Forced him out of the pocket. He had a run with the football. It was almost an interception. Let's take a look as we see McIver being chased. He does have a strong arm, as we mentioned. He can get the ball downfield, but the ball was thrown, a little underthrown, and could have been an interception.
The punter for Carolina will be Goodson, John Goodson. He averaged a little over 38 yards per punt during the season, and you'll notice his right foot is unshod. He aimed it for the left corner, but it gets into the end zone, and our first look coming up at the North Carolina offense. We have no score in the Bluebonnet Bowl in the Astrodome. 7 minutes left, first quarter. Oh, really?
You don't have the name.
There are some viewers that are listening to the show that unfortunately cannot see the phone numbers. The numbers are for yes, 1-900-720-8105. For no, 1-900-720-8606.
North Carolina, Rod Elkins, number 10 at quarterback. Amos Lawrence, all-conference. One of the outstanding running backs in the country. John Unitas mentioned before the start of the game, he joined Tony Dorsett as only the second player to have gained over 1,000 yards in each of his four collegiate years at North Carolina. Amos Lawrence, number 20, senior, Norfolk, Virginia. Billy Johnson, number 36, is an outstanding blocking back for Carolina. Second down. Elkins gets away from the rush. First down, Carolina 37-yard line. Good pass to Mike Chatham, who is listed as a number two tight end. But you know about him, John.
He is a number two tight end, but he's also the leading receiver for 2 years in a row. And they love to throw to him. The other starting tight end never has caught a pass this year. There's the avoiding of the rush right there. Could have had a nose guard grabbing, but he got away from him. There's a throw to Chatham. Fine reception, a good throw by Elkins.
The big rush was by Ken McCune, but Elkins got away from it. Lawrence, good second effort out to the 41-yard line. A gain of four, and Carolina has a second down six. No score. Only 6 minutes left to play, first quarter. Number 98 for North Carolina, Lawrence Taylor, their outstanding linebacker. Elkins sends the Tar Heels up to the line. Wide to the right, number 41, Wayne Tucker, a senior from Richmond, Virginia. Splitting out to the right is Robinson, the tight end. Carolina from the I formation. A big hole for Lawrence. 30. It's a foot race. Touchdown.
Offensive line does for Lawrence as they open up the quick trap on the hole. There's no one there. Lawrence just takes it, breaks back to his right, and it's I'll see you later, pal. Bobby Johnson, number 28, on the chase, but I don't think he has the speed to catch Lawrence.
Nine-yard run for the touchdown. Carolina went for two and failed. So with 5:29 left to play in the first quarter, an electrifying run for touchdown number 16 of this season by Amos Lawrence. North Carolina leads 6-0. Deep for Texas, a threesome in the middle. Is Walls. It will not be run out. Incidentally, I want to, as we look at this touchdown run, John Unitas, Bobby A.I. is our referee. Jim Harper, scheduled here, had a death in the family.
All right, let's take a look at the big blocks as you see Lawrence cut through the middle, break back to his right. The block downfield at number 28, Bobby Wall. Johnson is trying to catch it, but I don't think he's got a shot at it. Again, it's 6-4 points.
So 6-0, North Carolina, 80 yards, four plays, the last 59 by Lawrence, 6-0 here in the Astrodome, 5:29 left to play, first quarter. Burrowing to the left is Darrell Clark, the Houston sophomore.
We are conducting our phone survey. There is a charge for 50 cents, but this is the first time at a sporting event that you'll be able to vote for this question. Should there be a national playoff to determine a national champion? Thus far, the count, 33,348 yes, 2,389 have voted no.
For Texas, second down eight at the Longhorn 22-yard line. McCloney comes in motion to the right. McIver is the quarterback. McIver rolling. First down at the Texas 35, Les Koning. And he has a strong arm, Rick McIver, John.
McIver does have a very, very strong. He's got a rifle-type arm. He was telling us yesterday that he can throw the ball 80-some yards. There's a good move by McIver as he's coming out on the run. There's an excellent curl pattern right in the middle right there as you see the completion.
So Caney grabs off the pass. First down, Texas at the Longhorn 35. Caney wide to the right. There's Freddie Akers, the head man of Texas. One of the earphones on there. Quick opener, short yardage, 3 yards for Rodney Tate, the Beggs, Oklahoma junior. His running mate in the backfield at the moment is Carl Robinson. In with the play comes another running back, Mike Luck. He'll replace Robinson. So it'll be Luck, 26, Tate, 23, the Texas running back. Second down, 7, Texas 38-yard line. This is Mike Luck. Might have a first down with that last surge of 3 or 4 yards out across the Texas 45-yard line where Bill Jackson out of the secondary made the tackle.
Texas not afraid to run that ball against number 98, Lawrence Taylor, as he sticks his head in there. But so far, they've been very successful at doing it, running him out of the hole.
number 40 for North Carolina. First down, the Texas 40, let's call it 46-yard line. MacGyver on first down. Good protection. And a very, very good play by Billy Jackson, the junior for Winston-Salem. Good play.
Clooney just took that pattern a little far, too much into the inside. Had he stayed outside, MacGyver could have gotten the ball to him a lot quicker. As it was, it went in too far inside, and no way he was going to make the reception.
Make no doubt about it, we are in Texas. This is Longhorn country for a day at least. Second down, 10, Texas. There goes McCloney in motion. General direction of Rodney Tate, but good pressure that time applied. Say, they must have been blitzing there with Taylor.
They were coming back from the outside, and the ball, the play just took too long to develop to really do anything with it. Take a look at it from our end zone camera and see what happens. You see MacGyver on a rollout. He has adequate protection right there, but now he gets forced back to the outside again. He gets the pressure from behind, tries to get the ball downfield, but the ball, it just took too late to develop to get anything done with it.
So Texas, as a result, third and 10 at the Texas 46. Three wide receivers. Robinson, the only running back. Good protection. Pass complete. First down, 36-yard line. Lawrence Sampleton, the junior tight end.
Come on, Hunter.
There's a young man who went 59 yards, Amos Lawrence. But here's the last play again.
Let's take a look at MacGyver. As we mentioned earlier, he likes to stay in that pocket. He has a very, very strong arm looking for his receiver. They're mixing the ball, the game up very, very well with the rollouts and with the pocket pass. There you see the good throw, and he really got the ball down to Sampleton, number 87.
North Carolina substituting with standback defensively as Texas has moved to a first down at the North Carolina 36. Here's Mike Luck. Took it to the outside. We have not as yet seen A.J. Jam Jones, the junior running back from Youngstown, Ohio. From all of us to all of you, a very happy and a very healthy new year would be our wish. Luck picked up a couple. Second down, 8 at the North Carolina 35. 2:46 left to play. First quarter, 6-0. North Carolina leading. Would you like to see a playoff for the National Collegiate Football Championship? That's our question. More details of it later on the numbers to call. Robinson on a quick hitter gets to the 32. It will be 3rd and 5, North Carolina. I mean 3rd and 5, Texas, at the Carolina 32-yard line.
Texas again is moving the ball very well against that North Carolina defense. They don't seem to be afraid of them at all. And they're not afraid of Lawrence Taylor at all, number 98. They've been moving the ball well against him as well. And I think that that's going to be their game plan most of the evening. Keep it on the ground. Try to get downfield. At least get 6 points before we have another penalty somewhere.
Clark and Luck are the running backs. Here comes a rush. MacGyver. First down. A super individual effort by Rick MacGyver.
Let's take a look at MacGyver as it was back to throw, and he really evades the blitz coming in from the outside. Right there, he really gets away from the outside linebacker, regains his balance, looking for someone to throw downfield to. He likes to run the football and does very, very well when he does it. There he's trying to run over someone.
So, with 2:04 left to play in the first quarter, Texas trailing 6-0 to North Carolina. That's a first and 10 at the Carolina 25-yard line. Straight ahead goes Darrell Clark. And gets good yardage on first down, about 4 yards. Just an eyelash short of the 20-yard line of North Carolina. Carolina's been making a lot of substitutions defensively. Sent in Mike Wilcher at a linebacking spot a moment ago. And right now, Carolina decides it's time to talk things over. 1:49 left to play, first quarter. North Carolina leading 6-0 here in the Bluebonnet Bowl. T Texas, as Dick Crum, the head coach of North Carolina, looks on. Second and five, Texas, North Carolina 20. 1 minute, 49 seconds left to play first quarter. Carolina leading 6-0 on a 59-yard brilliant run by Amos Lawrence. Two wide receivers off to the right. McIver on second down, getting some pressure. He's throwing for McClooney. Too far. McClooney had a couple of steps on Bill Jackson, John.
He certainly did. We're going to take a look at it, hopefully. And the ball was just overthrown a little as McIver really was rushed and was hit as he was throwing the football.
Third down, 5 for Texas at the North Carolina 20. Howard?
Ray, thus far in our poll to the, whether or not the viewers want to see a national college playoff, 56,023 have voted yes, they would like to see it. 4,650 have voted no, they would not like to see it. We'll give you the phone numbers as we move along.
Third down and 5 for Texas. Great defensive play by North Carolina's Paul Davis, number 34, the senior nose guard from Appalachia, Virginia. It is 4th and 5.
That looked like Rick McIver tried a quarterback draw on that place, but the North Carolina Tar Heels didn't go for it.
A field goal attempt. As you look at the phone numbers, a field goal attempt by John Goodson, 37 yards. I don't know whether one of the Carolina players got a piece of it or not, but it's well off the target to the left. Carolina holds on to the lead. Uh-oh, I see a penalty flag just now. Our Southeastern Conference officials huddle. Did you see something, Vince Buckley, that we did not see?
I didn't observe anything yet. It must be a Texas movement in the line or offside. We'll wait for a signal.
Referee Bobby AI will be giving us the signal in a moment. Well, maybe he gave it and we didn't see it.
No, he didn't give one yet.
Here it is.
The marker was for a possible 7 men on the line of scrimmage. There were sufficient men on the line of scrimmage.
Had an illegal procedure. They didn't have 7 men on the line of scrimmage. Apparently one of the ends who was out was back in the backfield. We must have 7 men on the line of scrimmage. You can have more, but you must have at least 7.
Thank you, Vince Buckley. So, Carolina, 6-0, 1:09 left to play first quarter. First and 10, North Carolina at their 20-yard line. Total offense, Texas 122, Carolina 80. The new tailback is Kelvin Bryant instead of Lawrence. And here is Bryant. What a pair of tailbacks. John, between them, Amos Lawrence and Kelvin Bryant have gained over 2,200 yards this season.
Well, Kelvin Bryant had 1,039 yards and 12 touchdowns this year, playing behind Amos Lawrence. So you know what a tremendous job that their offensive backs are doing, and the offensive line are doing fantastically. Kelvin Bryant on a fine run. I know this makes Coach Crum very, very happy because he has Kelvin Bryant for 2 more years.
First down, Carolina at their 33. This time he goes to his fullback, Billy Johnson. The Buckingham, Virginia senior is noted mainly for his tremendous blocking, and that's one reason why Bryant and Lawrence have had the outstanding years that they have had. This indeed is a New Year's Eve tradition here in Houston at the Astrodome, the Bluebonnet Bowl, named after the state flower of Texas. I never knew that until earlier today. Shifting to tailback is number 44, Bryant. Second down, 7. Here comes Bryant. First down. The sophomore running back from Tarboro, North Carolina. That's worth a second look.
Let's take a look at it. We see Bryant coming through the line now. He's trying to find an open hole to go to. There it is, the hesitation. I'd go back to his right, then he really takes a pretty good shot. Right there. He gets it pretty well wrapped up, very fine by the Texas tacklers.
But we have reached the end of the first quarter. North Carolina, leading 6-0, will have the football, 1st and 10, at the Carolina 49-yard line. When we resume play at the start of the second quarter before an exuberant crowd in Houston.
thus far in our poll as to whether or not there should be a National College Championship playoff. 65,071 have voted yes, 5,493 have voted no. Telephone numbers, we'll give them to you both audio and visual for those folks that don't have the opportunity to actually see the telecast.
Carolina first down. Elkins going deep for his tailback, Robin. Bryant was all the way down to the 10-yard line, and Rod Elkins can throw very well deep.
He put that ball right on the money. It just happened to be a little too far for Bryant to get to the ball. But the ball was thrown very well with some good trajectory coming down. Just a little bit too far for Bryant to get to it. And Elkins was hit just as he was throwing the football. J.R. wears 19. J.O. did too. Who might he be?
Did you?
In fact, I still have him on.
All right, Lawrence replaces Bryant after Bryant had that deep pattern to run. So second down 10, North Carolina at their own 49-yard line. Now there was about a 4-yard loss turned into about a 2.5-yard gain by Amos Lawrence, despite a good defensive effort by senior Ken McCune of the Texas front line.
Lawrence and Dorsett have something in common. They both like to spin that way when they're getting hit and get away from a bad press.
New wide receiver for Carolina, number 39, Delbert Howell, replaces Tucker. Two wide receivers to the right, third and eight. Elkins on a deep drop back. Good play behind the line. Number 98. McCune again makes his presence felt. It is fourth down, and Texas plays very well.
That time, Bobby Johnson, number 28, came in on the blitz, too.
Deep for Texas will be Herky Walls. Punting for Carolina will be Steve Streeter. 43.4 is his average. A wall of blockers. Herky Walls. A great effort by North Carolina's Mike Marr.
Let's take a look at it. Herky Walls, as he circles around back in his backfield. Now watch the wall set up here on the right-hand side. There's one of them. Bingo, as Herky Walls gets on the outside. It makes an outstanding run, but is pulled down and the jersey torn practically off of his back.
So it is 6-0, North Carolina leading. Texas has the edge in yardage thus far. We played a minute 25 of the second quarter. We'll return after these messages from your local station. Fred Akers looks on, the highly successful head coach in Texas. His Longhorns have the ball and a short gain for fullback Darrell Clark. Just across the 30-yard line for Texas, it'll be second down, about 8.5 to go for a first down. Texas has the edge in yardage gain so far, 124 to 104, but of Carolina's 104, Amos Lawrence bit off 59 yards for the game's only score on a truly brilliant touchdown run. Wide to the right is Kiki Walls. To the left, Caney and McCloney. So three wide receivers. McCloney in motion. Fumble! Well, let's see after it gets sorted out who has it. It would appear that Joe Sharon recovered that fumble for Texas.
Let's take a look at it. As you see the ball bouncing around, all kind of people around. It looked like the Texas man, Sharon, got his hands in there and picked it up, still maintained the possession of the football.
So thanks to the alertness of Sharon, Texas retains possession, third and nine at the Texas 30. Diver has Mahoney going in motion. Good protection. Fine catch by Caney. First down at the Carolina 45-yard line.
Let's take a look at it from our ground level camera and watch the power that MacGyver has in that arm. As we've mentioned, he likes to stay in the pocket. He has excellent protection as he moves up, back up inside the pocket. Watch this throw, rifle-like throw down the field. A fine reception. The ball was just a little behind him.
And MacGyver was hurt on the play, John.
Coney makes a fantastic catch on it. MacGyver was hurt. He must have been hit late then.
He has left the game. It has forced Texas to take a timeout. He was able to walk off the field with some aid. So it will be, when the play resumes, a first down for Texas at the 45-yard line of North Carolina. 6-0. North Carolina leading early second quarter. The new quarterback is Donnie Little, the junior from Dickinson, Texas, replacing the slightly injured Rick MacGyver. First down, Texas, Carolina 46. This is Little, and here goes Kiki Walls. All the way inside the 5-yard line to the 3-yard line goes sophomore Kiki Walls from Garland, Texas.
Lawrence Taylor finally caught him before he got into the end zone. Ray was kicked all the way from over this his outside linebacker's position. Here we see the play coming back on the pitch. Herky Walls all the way down. Lawrence Taylor, number 98, finally catches him at the 3-yard line.
I got so excited I called him Kiki instead of Herky. It's first and goal to go after that 42-yard run by Texas to the North Carolina 3-yard line. And we have a timeout by Texas and a chance to look at that brilliant play again. Little to Walls.
Let's take a look at it. You see Little pitch it out to Walls. Herky Walls sets up some fine blocking. He has some good people downfield. I thought he was going to go all the way, but Lawrence Taylor, number 98, comes back from his outside linebacker position to finally make the tackle, as we see it right there.
So Lawrence Taylor prevents a touchdown for the moment at least. We're in the midst of a Texas timeout. 3 yards away from tying up this game. 11:48 left to play, second quarter. If you joined us a bit late, North Carolina scored on a 59-yard run by Amos Lawrence, but Texas is 3 yards away from a tie. Howard David, how does that poll stand?
Thus far, Raymond, our poll shows in this poll to determine whether or not there should be a national playoff to determine a national champion. The count, 80,479 for and 6,759 against. Again, those telephone numbers, if you want to vote yes, 1-900-720-8105.
Into the end zone goes Rodney Tate. And we have a tie, and Texas will have a chance to take the lead. Or did we have a penalty flag down?
He did not get into the end zone.
He did not get in. I saw one signal.
Looked awful good from up here.
Oh, I thought I saw one. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I got too excited. 2 feet away.
That's a good.
Looking at Coach Fred Akers there.
Little keeps it. He doesn't get in. Donnie Little on a keeper.
They're going against the number 11th ranked defensive team in the nation. So they're really going to have to get the offensive line to really move out if they expect to get it in there.
So it is going to be third and goal from inside the 1 yard line.
Ray, I did not get an opportunity to give the no phone number. It's 1-900-720-8606. Okay, let's go.
Third and goal, 2 feet away from a tie. And this time we do have a Texas touchdown. And the Longhorn fans are being heard in the Astrodome. Mike Luck, number 26, gets the TD.
Take a look at it right here. He's up over top. This time they get the offensive line has done the job on the Tar Heels from North Carolina. When we get in, we try to attempt to go ahead, aren't we?
Yeah. John Goodson, 29 of 31 extra points. And number 30 out of 32. And Texas has the lead with 10:37 left to play in the first half. Have an offensive show here in the Astrodome. The Longhorns 7, North Carolina 6. We'll be back after these messages from your local station. For the first time this year, number 44, Kelvin Bryant will be one of the deep return men. The other returner, Dick Harrison, number 9. So Bryant 44, Harrison number 9. Goodson comes to the ball early second quarter. Good kick. This will be Bryant. 5 yards deep. He will not run it out. His teammate Harrison says, nope. Use a little caution. 10:37 left to play, first half. Mike Luck scored the tying touchdown for Texas. Goodson put the Longhorns ahead by one. We note that Mike Chatham, number 88, will be the tight end for North Carolina.
The old rainbow head down there, did you notice that?
I just did. Rod Elkins directing the attack. Harrison is wide to the right. Chatham is out to the left. Chatham in motion. This is Amos Lawrence breaking one tackle and gets a couple of yards to the 22-yard line. Has Texas made any change in its defense here to slow down this running attack, John?
No, they haven't yet. The North Carolina team is offensive team is just taking it to them right now. Both teams seem to be having quite a bit of success at running the football against one another this evening. And you'll see, I think, that the North Carolina Tar Heels have a tremendous offensive line. That's why we've had some pretty good runs by those offensive backs, Taylor and Bryant.
Second down, 8. The draw. Lawrence showing why he is an outstanding running back. There was really good running.
This young man really picks the holes well as we watch right here. Elkins, as he hands off to Lawrence, picks the holes, comes back to the outside, almost evades the outside linebacker, but does pick up some good yards.
First down, 10-yard run by Lawrence to the North Carolina 32-yard line. Tight end Robinson has left the game. Tucker in motion. Elkins looking downfield. Well, Bryant that time, I think, made a mistake. Kelvin Bryant had a chance to take it upfield, but he came back and it hurt him.
He decided to come back and try and get beneath the defensive football team. Was not able to. Elkins looking downfield, finally gives the ball to Bryant. He decides to come back here, thinking he can get around, but to no avail as he's pulled down by number 98 of the defensive football team, the Texas Longhorn. 77 Sims has been injured on the play. He's just out for a short period.
Second down, 8, Carolina 34-yard line. Elkins getting some pressure now, got a little block. Couldn't quite get it to Harrison. Penalty flag down near the line of scrimmage. Penalty flag down near the line of scrimmage.
This is our total thus far in our poll as to whether or not there should be a national college playoff to determine a champion. Our telephone numbers, if you want to vote yes, 1-900-720-8105. To vote no, 1-900-720-8606. We should remind you there is a 50-cent charge.
Second down.
Holding against North Carolina. Second down. 24 for a first down. Carolina must reach the North Carolina 42-yard line. Time left to play first half, 8 minutes 46 seconds. Texas leading by the margin of an extra point, 7-6. Texas has McCune, Weber up front. I'm not sure whether Sims returned or not. This is Bryant to the 23-yard line, a pickup of about 5. It will be third down at about 20. As in with the play comes Delbert Powell, one of the Carolina wide receivers. He'll replace Tucker. And Mark Smith, a freshman receiver from Fayetteville, North Carolina, is also in the lineup. Two wide receivers to the right. Bryant moves over in a slot right. The only setback is Billy Johnson. Elkins gets it to the 29-yard line, but it'll bring up fourth and still about 13 as Doug Schenkel makes the tackle.
Elkins did some fancy stepping to get out of that hole as we see a linebacker coming in from the outside. Let's watch him dance around through the tulips right there and trying to get down as quickly as possible. There's the punt, a tremendous...
Oh, Steve Streeter really got his leg into it. And dropped deep in Texas territory was Herky Walls back inside the 15 around the 11-yard line. So Streeter lives up to his great reputation. He's been averaging over 43 yards per punt. 7-6 Texas. We believe we have a new Blue Bonnet Bowl record for a punt. 63 yards by Streeter. The old one was 61. So Texas backed up to the Texas 12-yard line. McIver is back at quarterback. Fortunately, his injury was not serious. This one is picked off by Steve Streeter, who had that great punt a moment ago.
Streeter was just back there playing center field on that one, Ray. MacGyver threw the ball long, overshot his receiver. Streeter could have called for a fair catch, elected to pick it up. A fine interception by Streeter. That's number 12 for his career.
So first down, Maryland, Texas 34-yard line.
The ball was intercepted. It was by Streeter. It was intended for Sampleton, the tight end. There you see Streeter running around trying to find a place to fall down so they don't get hurt.
Elkins, a quarterback. Johnson, the fullback. Here comes the end around. This is Tucker. 30, 25, 20, 10, inside the five. It was either Mark Smith or Wayne Tucker. It was Mark Smith.
Let's take a look at it. Take a look at it from the ground level camera. As you see, Elkins come out and hand the ball off to 45. Smith, and he's going down the sideline. Some good blocking in front of him as he tries to outdistance the blockers now and get into the end zone as quickly as possible. And he's brought down.
So each team has had great runs on the end-around play. Walls for Texas. Smith. Here is Amos Lawrence. Did he get in? He did not. He got to about the 1 foot line, did Amos Lawrence, who scored the first touchdown of the game on a 59-yard run. 6:40 left to play in the first half. And is this ball moving? Texas has picked up 192 yards. North Carolina has picked up 161 yards. Total offense. And a rather worried Freddie Akers, head coach of Texas, along the far sidelines. Second and goal to go, Carolina. 1 foot away from taking the lead over Texas. Bryant. Kelvin Bryant. Replaced Lawrence at tailback and takes it into the end zone.
No doubt about that. Was some good offensive blocking up front by this David Dressler and Bob Wooten. Offensive guard, All-American. Outstanding block.
This unusual formation by North Carolina. They lined up on the left hash mark. Now they apparently are going to go for the single point conversion. And it is good. Jeff Hayes adds point number 13. Carolina has regained the lead over Texas. 13-7, 6:15 to play, first half. In the middle is Herky Walls, whose brilliant run set up the Texas touchdown. On the right is Alfred Fields. On his left is Mossy Cade. It will not be run out as it goes over the end line for the touchback. So Texas trailing now 13-7. Number 53 for Texas. Now there's the Texas quarterback, Rick McIver. The interception of McIver's first pass after returning to action after a slight injury. Picked off by Carolina Streeter. And that set up the second North Carolina touchdown.
Texas has been fairly successful running that football against North Carolina. See if they don't come out with it again.
Mike Luck gets a yard. MacGyver's wide receivers are Les Koenig, number 13, and McCloney has been in the main the other wide receiver.
Ray, we received a telephone call from folks in Louisiana. The referee's name is Aya.
Aya.
Football stadium at Louisiana Tech is named after his father, a longtime coach at Louisiana Tech.
All right. Second down, 9, Texas. MacGyver back to his own 10. Gets out to about the 26-yard line. Yes, he is substituting for James Harper, who had to withdraw as referee because of a death in the family, we are told.
I believe it's either Aya or Aye. Either way, the folks in Louisiana paying attention.
For Texas, 3rd and 4 at the Texas 26-yard line. 5.5 minutes remain in the first half. Both teams have shown a great ability to move the football. Texas was hurt early by penalties, then North Carolina was hurt by penalties. Carolina has the lead by 6. A 3rd and 4 for Texas. This is Mike Locke. Fumble. Carolina has it.
The ball took a North Carolina bounce as Luck gets it knocked out of his hand. The ball bounces right back up into Streeter's arms, number 5. So far tonight, he's playing an outstanding ball game. This was just a short screen, a running screen, as he has 3 men in front of him. Gets the ball knocked out. Watch the bounce for North Carolina as it bounces 1 time right up into Streeter's arm.
So Streeter, who intercepted a moment ago, now recovers a fumble at the Texas 33-yard line. Carolina sends Mark Smith out to the left. He carried that end around inside the 5-yard line to set up the second Carolina touchdown. That's Tucker in motion. This is Amos Lawrence. He's going to throw a left-handed pass. Batted down at the goal line on a fine play by Bill Graham, the junior free safety for Texas, and he recovered in a hurry.
He did, but Lawrence had the short man open, and he should have gone to short man because he was completely open. He elected to go for the touchdown, but the defensive man was back there and did the job.
So for Carolina, into the bag of tricks, using Lawrence to throw. 2nd down 10 at the Texas 33. Elkins, the quarterback, has 1 wide receiver this time off to the right. And that would be Wayne Tucker. Now he splits out to the left. Lawrence. 1st down at the 20-yard line. Brilliant running by Amos Lawrence.
There's some outstanding blocking on that left side, too. As we watch Amos take the handoff, break through the line, and pick up some great yardage. This man is quite a runner with the ball.
Lawrence picked up 12 and leaves the game. He'll be replaced by Kelvin Bryant, number 44. 1st down, North Carolina at the Texas 20. Tucker goes to the left. Mark Smith to the right. Bryant, little delay, 6 yards. Before he's brought down by Ken Sims, the outstanding defensive tackle for Texas, number 77.
Last year, Sims was credited with making 100 defensive tackles and 31 other assists, and also recovered 4 fumbles for Texas. Outstanding defensive tackle for the Texas Longhorns.
New tight end, Shelton Robinson, number 80, checked in for Carolina. Tucker will again go to the wide side of the field, the left. 2nd down 4 at the Texas 14-yard line. Bryant, good defensive effort by middle linebacker Doug Schenkel, just a sophomore, number 48. Might have been a bit of a loss on the play, about 2 yards. It'll be 3rd and 6.
It's New Year's Eve here in Houston, Texas, as we can see all the well-dressed people here waiting for the game to be over.
Bringing in the play selection, tight end Mike Chatham, number 88. 2 wide receivers, 1 each side, 3rd and 6. Bryant in a slot to the right. Tucker in motion. This is a 3rd and 6 play. Bryant, the receiver, short of a 1st down around the 12-yard line. It will be fourth and about 2.5 or 3. And we will have an attempt at a field goal, it would appear, by Jeff Hayes.
Here's a look at number 83 for the Texas Longhorns. Mr. Howell, tight end.
This will be a 30-yard field goal attempt by Jeff Hayes. The holder is the substitute quarterback, Stan Cabbage. Not good. Wide of its target. So the score remains North Carolina 13, Texas 7. 2 minutes, 48 seconds left to play in the first half. First down at the Texas 20. McIver, the quarterback. Little delay. Good run by fullback Darrell Clark. Gets about 8 yards on first down out to the 28-yard line.
A good call by McIver. He has been throwing the football on first down. If you're going to do that, you certainly have to draw on first down as well to keep the defense honest.
We've been asking this question all night. Should there be a national championship? If you want to vote yes, you have a number that you'll get in on your screen in a moment. Or if you want to vote no, you'll also have a telephone number in which to call. There is a 50-cent charge.
Here comes Carl Robinson. Runs into traffic after getting a first down out across the 30-yard line. So Texas, which has a slight edge in total yardage, 213 to North Carolina's 182, but Carolina leads on the scoreboard 13-7, and Darrell Clark brings in the play and replaces Carl Robinson in the backfield as Freddie Akers. McIver, good protection. Mike Luck. Mike Luck, the intended receiver around the 35-yard line. Defending was Sammy Johnson, a sophomore from Reading, Pennsylvania, who is playing that free safety spot at the moment. He's in there along with Streeter.
The ball was thrown very long by McIver. Not a good throw at all. Could possibly have had an interception there, except for Luck just knocked the ball out of the defender.
Second down, 10 at the Texas 33. Clock shows 2 minutes, 2 seconds left to play first half. I do not know. Oh, I see. Some of the Carolina players were getting too much involved in the game. I think they were going. Is Vince Buckley, were they going out onto the field?
That's right. There's a 6-foot area there behind the sideline. That's no man's land. And during the time the ball is in play, it's supposed to be clear. They're entitled to 2 warnings before they're penalized. That's a new rule this year.
That was the voice of Vince Buckley, who has been with us last week at the Hall of Fame Bowl and again tonight. Long time and now retired Southwest Conference official and president of the Bluebonnet Bowl. McCloney is wide to the right. And McCloney comes in motion. Screen pass. This is Robinson. And he gets it out to the 38-yard line. Carl Robinson, the Temple, Texas sophomore. Texas will have a 3rd and 6 at the Texas 38-yard line. We want you to vote in our poll. We'll shortly be showing you those phone numbers again. If you believe there should be a playoff for the National Collegiate Championship, you have a chance to vote yes, or if you're against it, you can vote no. Oh. There was a fine defensive play by Bratton, although Texas fans thought it should have been interference.
Let's take a look at the play here. A fine defensive play by the defensive back, number 3 of Carolina. That was Bratton. Came right over top of his shoulder and knocked the ball out of his grasp. Excellent play.
Barefooted kicker John Goodson will be kicking it away for Texas with just over a minute to play in the first half. Oh, he gets a beauty. A beauty. To the Carolina 15-yard line, Greg Poole. And that punt was covered very well. So North Carolina has two timeouts remaining. Texas has but one. Carolina possession at the North Carolina 20-yard line. All the way at quarterback for the Tar Heels has been Rod Elkins. He's only a sophomore from Greensboro. The tailbacks have been alternating as they have all season long, Lawrence and Bryant. Billy Johnson has been the fullback. Bryant is currently in at the one running back spot. This is Bryant. And very little there. Sims, for one, had him in his grasp, along with linebacker Bruce Schultz. And Walter Sturtevant is now the fullback, number two instead of Johnson.
You're not going to run over Sims too many times in this football game. He's a tremendous tackler. He has great agility for a man his size. Number 77.
No gain as a result of Sims' play along with Schultz. Second and 10. Less than a minute remaining in the first half. Elkins looking downfield and overthrows. That stops the clock with 33 seconds left to play in the half. A lot of interesting halftime activity to pass your way, including your continuing opportunity to vote on the question, which has been discussed over and over again by those we would refer to as the powers that be. Should there be a playoff to decide the collegiate football championship? You have a chance tonight to vote on that question. We'll give you all the details right at the end of the half. Third and 10, North Carolina. North Carolina elected not to put the ball in the air.
Let's take a look at Sims, number 77, on this play, see how he reacts. There you see him coming back to the inside, taking an inside charge on the offensive blocker, and comes across and then makes an assist on the tackle.
Result, gain of a little more than a yard. It is fourth down, 28 seconds, all that remains. And we have, to the best of our knowledge, although it's unofficial, Streeter will be punting to Herky Walls, but Streeter has set a Bluebonnet Bowl record with a 63-yard punt. He has intercepted a pass and recovered a fumble. Steve Streeter, whose brother was an outstanding player several years back at Tennessee. Low snap, controlled. He had to hurry that punt. But it'll be down with less than 20 seconds remaining in the half.
With 18 seconds left.
Texas has no timeouts remaining. First down at the Texas 39-yard line. 18 seconds remaining in the half. Koenig to the left. Walls to the right. Letting it all hang out for Walls. Good play by the Carolina defensive back. That would have been Tyrus Bratton, who made a good play the last time Texas had the ball.
He made an excellent play on that one as well, as he was back in his coverage. We mentioned how strong an arm MacGyver had prior to the ball game, and he can just turn it loose and let it fly as he does right here. Both men going up for the ball, and they're both entitled. Fine defensive play.
That play took 7 seconds. Second and 10 at the Texas 39, 11 seconds remaining in the half. Three wide receivers. Good protection. This one is intended for Koenig. Oh, he almost got it on the rebound of the 10-yard line, did Les Koenig.
That ball bounced right down into his arms on the backside of it. Let's see if we can get a good shot of it coming off of the defensive player's hands.
That was Sammy Johnson defending.
Keating's down on the ground. Watch right down here as the ball comes down right on his head. He just didn't see it, right?
3 seconds now remaining in the half. Sampleton is out to the right. Walls is out to the right. There are three wide receivers. MacGyver under pressure. almost picked off on the final play. Texas has the lead in yardage at the half, 224 to 183 for North Carolina. Good height, Bryant at the one. Look out! Kelvin Bryant, one half of that great tailback duo, John, he can fly.
There's some outstanding blocks up front to break a hole open there for Bryant as he came flying up the middle and almost broken for the score.
So this Rod Elkins-directed offense of North Carolina will start from the Carolina 45-yard line. Wayne Tucker, number 41, goes left. Mark Smith, number 45, comes right. Billy Johnson at fullback. Amos Lawrence at tailback. Tucker in motion. Amos Lawrence. Woo! He ran into one of the linebackers. That was Doug Shankle, the middle backer, number 48.
Also number 77, Sims, in on that tackle.
Gain, 2 yards. Second down, 8. Carolina 47. In with the play, Delbert Powell, senior from Elizabeth City, North Carolina. Offensive line of Drexler, Wooten, Donnelly, Spruill, and Marr. Second down, 8. The fullback in motion, Johnson. And a penalty flag down as Lawrence carries to the Texas 47-yard line. But a penalty flag is down.
Kenneth Sims on a good pursuit pattern coming up with the tackle on that. But we do have a penalty flag.
Illegal motion. So forget the gain of about 5.
Still first down.
That's a question that we have been asking our viewers throughout the evening. We are getting an average of 1,500 calls per minute. There's the telephone numbers. Thus far, 140,000 plus have voted yes. Only 12,000 have voted no.
Second down, 14 at the North Carolina 42-yard line. Elkins gives to Lawrence. Look at that move. Oh, and did he take a hit? Doug Shankle hit him first, then Bobby Johnson. No gain, third down, 8, North Carolina 47. I'll take that back. It was a gain of about 5 yards. Third down, 8. Lawrence is off to the right in the slot. Tucker in motion. Elkins looking. Penalty flag down. In and out of the hands of Lawrence. But a penalty flag down.
Ray, I believe you've got an illegal procedure there. Looked like that man was off the line. We don't have 7 men on the line.
Same penalty as before, Vince?
Right, same thing. This wing back over here is lining up behind, and he's supposed to be on the line, and the other flanker who's in motion starts out behind the line, and they end up with 6 men on the line of scrimmage.
So the Texas players looking over toward Freddie Akers, their head coach. See what the decision is.
Illegal procedure. Decline. 4 down.
4th down, 8. So another opportunity to watch the great kicking of Steve Streeter. He has a 63-yarder to his credit. The deep man is Herky Walls. Streeter has a Bluebonnet Bowl record 63-yard punt tonight. Hangs this one high and short. That was not a typical Streeter punt.
It sure wasn't. It did go out of bounds. It was effective in a way that did not have any type of rundown.
So Texas will have the football, trailing North Carolina 13-7. The Texas offensive line, Tobolka, Dawson, Babb, Studdard, and Tausch. Donnie Little, the quarterback. Clark and Luck, the running backs. This is Clark. A little bit of a seam and gets it out for about 3 to the 33. Darrell Clark.
Lawrence Taylor, number 98, plays this extremely well as we have an ISO on him. Let's watch the play of number 98, the All-American. Lawrence Taylor playing the blocker down, moving to the outside, forcing the ball carry inside, and then assist on the tackle. Excellent play by Lawrence Taylor.
Result, the gain is limited to 3, second down 7 at the Texas 33. North Carolina leading 13-7 early third quarter. Donnie Little keeps it to the 37, where it'll be 3rd and 3.
As we mentioned at the top of the game, that Donnie Little is primarily a running type quarterback. He does throw the rollout and has improved quite a bit on his passing ability. But he is the second leading rusher for Texas this season at 486 yards.
The 5-yard pickup sets up Texas 3rd and 3 at the Texas 37. Wide to the left is McCloney. Off to the right is Caney. Little on a straight drop back. Pass ever got through. North Carolina appeared to have one defender after another there, but somehow Les Caney came up with it.
It looked like a clean interception as he was throwing the football right here. I don't know how in the world it got through the man's hands, but it does. Les Caney comes up with the reception, almost drops the football. Might be interesting to note that Les Caney's father is Rice's coach here in town. I don't know how they let him get away to Texas.
All right, 1st and 10 at the Carolina 49. Little on first down. This time he misses his wide receiver, the same Les Caney, at the 35-yard line, and it'll be 2nd down 10, Texas.
Folks in Houston today were hit with some shocking news, weren't they? With the departure of one Bum Phillips as the head football coach of the Oilers.
To say that it was the topic of conversation from mid-afternoon on would be a vast understatement.
Without question.
2nd down 10, Texas at the Carolina 49. Caning is off to the near side this time. He's only 166 pounds and 5'9". Whoa! Little, after the fake to Robinson, is decked by Lawrence Taylor, the all-everything linebacker from Carolina. All the way back at the Texas 41-yard line, he didn't buy that fake at all.
He did. He really took a shot, too. I believe that is Taylor's 17th quarterback sack of the year, as here he comes. Oh, the orange blossom special, it looked like, coming in there.
3rd down. And about 20 yards for a 1st down. McCloney moves in motion. 3 wide receivers in for Texas. Pretty good protection. That time, Koenig started to come back. He ran a little hook, or whatever you want to call it, out to the sideline, and the pass was too deep, so they misread the pattern, and it's 4th down.
There you see Coach Akers talking to Little as he comes off the field. Wonder what happened on that pattern.
Goodson to punt. Greg Poole to receive at the Carolina 20. Good height, fair catch, pool, North Carolina, 22-yard line. So Carolina with the football, a 6-point lead, 10:31 to play, 3rd quarter. The tailback will be Lawrence. The fullback will be Billy Johnson. North Carolina's offensive line, Mark Sugg, Ron Wooten, Rick Donnelly, Ron Spruill. The Texas linebackers made the defensive play, and substitution, Mike Chatham at tight end, number 88, sent in by that man, Dick Crum, who has an outstanding coaching record. 2nd down 7, Carolina. Chatham lines up on the right side. Elkins, beautiful pass for a 1st down after the 39-yard line to the man who just checked into the game, Mike Chatham.
Mike Chatham is a fine receiver. As we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, that he is the leading receiver for the North Carolina team Might be interesting to note, too, that the number one tight end, Sheldon Robinson, has no catches this year whatsoever.
His blocking ability has given him the starting assignment. First down at the North Carolina 39-yard line. Three wide receivers this time. Lawrence ran into Bruce Schultz, one of the linebackers.
Thus far in our total, we have 149,364 voted yes, this should be a national championship playoff, and only 13,300 have voted no.
There. Was that a look at Lawrence Taylor there a moment ago? I think so. At any rate, second down nine. Lawrence picked up a yard on first down. Johnson in motion, and here comes Bryant. And Texas appears to have tightened up its defense against the run.
The line is getting as much better movement out of that offensive line as they were in the first half.
And here is number 98, Lawrence Taylor, the all-everything linebacker. I believe it was Barry Switzer, the Oklahoma coach, who said of Taylor that he was absolutely the most active linebacker he had ever seen.
You're exactly right, Ray.
All right, third and six is the play. Elkins looking. There's Chatham again at the 41-yard line of Texas. Elkins throwing very well on the run.
They have been not giving him real good protection. They did in the first half. There you see Elkins on the run. There's a throw to Chatham who makes a fine catch on the football. Whenever he's in there, you know that they're going to throw the football to him.
So Carolina has something going. First down at the 41-yard line of Texas. 8 minutes left to play, third quarter. This time, three wide receivers. A little bit too low for Delbert Howell, the Elizabeth City senior. It'll be second down 10.
There's a picture of Lee Schaefer on the sidelines. Everyone's happy here so far.
Second down 10. Just joined us. We're at the Bluebonnet Bowl in the Astrodome in Houston. Third quarter finds North Carolina leading Texas 13-7. 7 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the third period as Wayne Tucker, the Richmond, Virginia senior, number 41, checks in. Wide to the left is Vic Harrison along with Tucker. Chatham has a gain of about 9, maybe 8, to the Texas 33. And
Elkins really threw that football, put a lot of spin on it, and Chatham was up to the reception. As they had pretty good coverage on him right there, but he makes an excellent catch.
And one of the Texas players shaken up on the play, and this will occasion a timeout here in the Astrodome with 7:34 remaining third quarter. Would you believe right now the total yardage? Texas 236, North Carolina 233. Doug Schenkel, the sophomore middle linebacker, will be replaced by Larry Ford, a sophomore from Dallas.
Schenkel's made an awful lot of tackles out there this evening. He'll be sorely missed.
Third and two, North Carolina, Texas 33. Play. Who was that from Texas? Ken McCune, the Lake Jackson senior, spotted Elkins and made a great play.
Well, he came back on a bootleg, did not hide the ball as well as he thought he wanted to. Does not go for the fake as he comes, starts one inside, then comes right back to the outside, and he's up to making the play on Elkins.
So very great quickness. Play. It's fourth and two, no gain on the play, and North Carolina believes it is four down territory. They're going for the first down. Fourth and two at the Texas 33.
They have tremendous confidence in that offensive line of theirs, and they're going to try to blow it out there, I'm sure.
I'm not sure whether a timeout has been called here. No, it is not. Just a brief lull in the proceedings. Meanwhile, Billy Johnson checked in at fullback, replacing Walter Sturdivant. Maybe they made a change in the play selection. North Carolina fans are standing here in the Astrodome. Fourth and two at the Texas 33. And here comes Bryant. He has a first down. The speed of Kelvin Bryant enabled him to get outside, and Larry Ford was able to run him out of bounds, but Bryant picks up a big first down.
Also a fine block by the fullback on the outside, number 36, Billy Johnson. Let's take a look at Billy Johnson's block right here as he comes up. Well, we don't get a chance to see it, but there's Bryant on the outside who picks up the first down.
So there's the first down by Bryant. First down, North Carolina. Whoop! Might have been a false move by, it looked like Ron Wooten, maybe the left guard, might have made a false move. Is that what you saw, Vince Buckley?
Right, and he should be set with his hands at or below his knees and his can't move. It's number 57, I believe, the left tackle, who made his move once he was set. Once those interior linemen get set, they cannot move. It's a foul whether the other team moves or not. It's automatic.
So a five-yard penalty moves the ball back to the Texas 32. It will be first and 15. Ball declared ready for play. First and 15, North Carolina, leading Texas 13-7, 6:44 left to play, third quarter. Harrison is wide to the left. Tucker is wide to the left. Amos Lawrence never had a chance because Ken Sims was waiting for him. And Sims wound up with the football, but I do believe it was dead before he got it. That's a dream, of course, of every defensive lineman to be allowed to continue on his journey.
To score that touchdown, that's for sure. I mean, he thought he had a Christmas present earlier, but he's already down.
Loss?
Late.
2 yards. 3 yards. Second down. 18 at the Texas 35. Powell is wide to the left along with Harrison. Bryant the tailback. Big hole to the 30. 5 yards. North Carolina will have a third and 13 at the Texas 30. Sims has that ability that every great defensive player has. He's always around the football.
Got great quicknesses and great agility for a man his size, and they really work on him during the summer camp. Coach was telling me that they really put the guys and puts a lot of pressure on him to become a fine football player, and he has.
Sturdivant is in at fullback. Three wide receivers left, including Bryant. Great pressure by Texas. Forces Elkins out of bounds near the Texas 40-yard line. There was fine defensive play.
Those are the numbers to call if you'd like to register your vote as to whether or not there should be a national collegiate championship playoff to determine a national champion. Thus far, 150,000 plus have voted yes, 13,000 plus have voted no.
Streeter to punt to Walls. Going to try and hang this high. Oh, boy, does he kick that one high. Fair catch. It's tough to handle. But it was handled very well by Herky Walls at the Texas 16-yard line. 5 minutes, 15 seconds left to play third quarter. Carolina by six. Freddie Akers looks on. His Longhorns have the ball at their own 16-yard line. Rick McIver is back in at quarterback. He started the game. This is Mike Luck. Boy, he ran into somebody and stopped in a hurry after about a yard pickup.
Both defenses seem to have really tightened up and have been stopping one another out there. We haven't had much scoring here in the second half, practically nothing in the third quarter at all. And they seem to be settling down and tightening up the defense, not giving the big play like they had previously.
Lee Schaffer made the defensive play. Luck gained only a yard. Second down, 9 at the Texas 17. Here comes Darrell Clark. Did not get a first down. Looked like he had pretty good running room, but Bill Jackson out of the secondary made a good, good play.
Bill Johnson, number 28, on the play. Let's take a look at the draw here. Here he comes on the draw. Let's watch Billy Johnson come over and make the play. He was trying to get outside the best he possibly could, but Johnson was right there, grabbed him by the jersey and pulled him down.
Third down, 5 at the Texas 21. Third quarter has been scoreless. MacGyver. Hit very hard. Incomplete pass. His arm came forward. No fumble. Hit very hard by Lawrence Taylor, who is living up to everything we heard about him.
He is quick and he does move.
With great pleasure, the 1980 Bluebonnet Bowl recognizes the man who will be honored later tonight by the Texas Gulf Coast chapter of the Leukemia Society of America at their second annual New Year's Eve party at the Galleria Plaza Hotel. The man whose dream was this Astrodome, whose inspiration was a guiding force in the early years. And meanwhile, we have a wild scramble at the 15-yard line of Texas.
Let's take a look at the players. We see what happens here. There it is. It hits his hands. He drops it. And, brother, is that a lonely feeling to have happen to you? And here comes all the big rush, and you're trying to pick it up and do something with it to get it out of there. There's a recovery by number 35 of the North Carolina football team.
John Goodson is the man who tried to get that punt away. We'll tell you in a moment that we're talking about the Honorable Judge Roy Hoffines a moment ago, but right now, Carolina at the Texas 15-yard line. Bryant goes in motion. And there goes fullback Walter Sturdivant to about the 11-yard line. A gain of 4 yards for Sturdivant to the Texas 11. Second down, 6. Delbert Powell, a wide receiver, brings the play in from Coach Dick Crum and his staff. Just over 3 minutes to play, third quarter. North Carolina leading by 6. Elkins on a rollout. And manages to get down to about the 9-yard line for a gain of 2. And North Carolina will have a 3rd and 4 at the Texas 9 as Robin Sendline made the tackle, the Las Vegas, Nevada linebacker.
That was a run all the way with Elkins carrying. They had no intention of trying to throw that football. He's trying to get outside, hoping that Elkins could break back and pick up some good yardage or possibly get into the end zone.
Harrison is sent out to the left by Elkins. Penalty flag. I think we had a false move by Delbert Powell, who was lined up on the left side, number 39. Howard David, I think you have a very special announcement to make.
Well, I have a very special guest. He's Ken Reeves, representative of the Citizen Watch Company. Citizen, of course, the official timepiece of the Mizlou Television Network and the Bluebonnet Bowl. We come to Houston. It's always good to see you.
Thank you, Howard. Good to see you again. As always, it's a pleasure to be the official watch for the Bluebonnet Bowl, and I'm sure the people receiving the watches will enjoy them for many years to come.
Our recipient of the Citizen Watch today is Carrie McDonald, the executive director of the National High School Athletic Coaches Association, a guy that's done a marvelous job.
Fantastic.
All right, North Carolina, 3rd and 10 after that 5-yard penalty. Elkins looking to the end zone. No, around the 4-yard line. Intended for Wayne. No, it was intended for Powell.
Let's take a look at this one. Here comes Elkins running a rollout out here. There's the throw to see if he could possibly come up with a catch. We can't get a good look at it, but the official was right on it and called it exactly the way it was supposed to be, out of bounds.
We'll have a field goal attempt. Scott Stankavage, the holder. Jeff Hayes will try a 31-yard field goal. And Stankavage is on target. North Carolina's lead. Uh-oh, penalty flag, penalty flag.
Ray, they can decline that field goal if they want to and take the 15-yard penalty for roughing the kicker is what happened.
He actually roughed the holder, I believe, didn't he, Vince, number 14?
The holder, Stan Cabbage. The place kicker, Jeff Hayes, started over toward the sidelines. Here's the announcement.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, decline, field goal is good.
Two weeks ago, our cameras made a trip to the National Football Hall of Fame at Kings Island, Ohio, to be with Bill Boswell.
That's Walls deep for Texas. That 15-yard penalty was measured off right here. Is that right, Vince Buckley?
Ray, they elected to take the points, and I'll talk about it later.
Short kick. Nowhere to go for Herky Walls. And he winds up all the way back at the Texas 5-yard line. And now, Vince Buckley, we can ask you to explain why the kickoff from where it was.
Yeah, well, they elected to take the field goal instead of the penalty, which is a puzzle, but coaches do not like to take points off the board. Had they accepted the penalty from the 20-yard line, it would have been half the distance. They'd have had first down on the 10. But they elected to keep the point on the board, and they still get the penalty on the kickoff, which puts it on the 45 of Texas.
Texas now deep at their own 5-yard line. MacGyver is the quarterback. Short yardage for Mike Luck. Up to about the 7.5-yard line. We're down now to where less than 2 minutes remain in the third quarter, and Carolina, that last field goal, John Unitas, a very important one.
It sure was, and I still don't understand why they elected to decline it, because if I moved it on down there, you got a chance for three more downs and a touchdown. I certainly would have wanted to take that one. But this defense is going to be very, very hard to beat right now. The momentum is in their favor, and they are really kind of shutting Texas off. Texas runs off at this point.
Carl Robinson gets it out to the 14-yard line, where Texas will have a third and a little more than one, as Harry Standback, the senior from Rockingham, North Carolina, made the tackle. Less than a minute will remain of the third quarter when center Mike Babb snaps the ball to Rick MacGyver. Texas has a slight edge in overall yardage, 243 to Carolina's 237. Great defensive play by North Carolina. Who's on the bottom? Number 94. Stand back again, among others. Result, loss. Texas will apparently have to kick it away. So John Goodson, who was unable to get the punt away the last time he was in punt formation, and it cost Texas a North Carolina field goal. There's Greg Poole standing back just a shade on the North Carolina side of the 50. Good punt. Poole at the North Carolina 39. Runs it back to the 48-yard line, and that's where North Carolina will have the football on what turns out to be the final play of the third quarter. North Carolina 16, Texas 7. North Carolina, first down play. And Kelvin Bryant is nailed by linebacker Bruce Schultz near the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 10. The only scoring in the second half, a field goal by North Carolina's Jeff Hayes, upping the Carolina lead from 13-7 to 16-7. Harrison is wide to the left. Here comes Bryant. Fumble. I believe Carolina retains possession, as Kelvin Bryant did a little bit of ad-libbing.
He certainly did. He got caught coming back to the outside over here. Watch the tackle right there. He's got a hand on, grasp on his legs and loses it. He decides to go back the other way and look for a moment like he was going to go the distance. He goes back up to the inside, 28, almost gets him. Kelvin Bryant with a fine run and then fumbles as he goes out of bounds. number 44, and you can see how he was able to pick up 1,039 yards this past season.
Bryant takes a break. Amos Lawrence replaces him. Here goes Lawrence, but not very far. Lawrence, who scored the game's first TD on a 59-yard run, gets a helping hand from cornerback Mike Hatchett. Dewey Turner made the tackle on the play.
Ray, I think it's interesting to see that the wide receiver who comes out to the official now is pointing down to see where the line of scrimmage is so he can be sure to get on it.
That was the voice of Vince Buckley, the former Southwest Conference official, here to get things squared away for us. Elkins on second and 10. That's very close to a first down. The fullback, Walter Sturdivant, the Hamlet, North Carolina senior. The ball at the 23-yard line of Texas, and it is a Carolina first down.
Let's take a look at the play. You see Elkins on a fake, rolling back to his left, coming out. There's the throw to Sturdivant. Fine catch. Tries to avoid a tackle as he comes down. First down for North Carolina. And they've got the momentum going again their way.
Bryan is back in. Lawrence comes out. Tucker came in motion. This pass is complete to Kelvin Bryant. It's another Carolina first down, and North Carolina has its offense in high gear now, as Mike Hatchett out of the secondary had to make the tackle and appears to have been shaken up. Number two, San Antonio's Mike Hatchett.
They're not doing anything fancy, just rolling out to the right, rolling out to the left. Halfback coming out of the backfield is wide open. The linebacker does not pick him up. He's able to make the reception and pick up some good yardage. Calvin Bryant again, and there's Hatchett on the tackle as he really gets belted right on the head. And I'm sure the bells of St. Mary's were ringing in his helmet there.
That first down moved North Carolina about 1 foot inside the Texas 10-yard line as Mike Hatchett receives attention. Incidentally, a little while ago, we made mention of the fact that to be honored later tonight was the late Judge Roy Hoffhines. Play resumed a little bit quicker than we thought it would be, and we want to make absolutely certain that we mentioned the late judge whose dream was this Astrodome. Incidentally, North Carolina's Rick Donnelly earned selection recently as one of 33 football winners of a $2,000 NCAA postgraduate scholarship. Donnelly, their outstanding offensive center, has a 3.56 grade point average in business administration. Seven other NCAA scholarship winners have played or will play in bowl games this year. Randy Schleusner of Nebraska, Jeff Finn of Nebraska, they played in the Sun Bowl, of course. Tom Gibbons of Notre Dame in the Sugar Bowl, Jay Jimerson of Oklahoma in the Orange Bowl. More names a bit later, back to play, first goal to go, Carolina, just inside the Texas 10-yard line. Here comes Amos Lawrence, and a loss of about two. The fumble occurred after the ball was dead. The other names I wanted to mention among those scholarship winners, postgraduate scholarship winners, Navy's Ted Dumball, who played in the Garden State Bowl, Penn State's John Walsh, who participated in the Fiesta Bowl, and Darrell Burkell of McNeese State, who participated in the Independence Bowl.
Ray, what makes me happy is when you talk about scholar-athletes, because not enough emphasis is placed on that form of what goes on in college sports.
It is second and goal to go North Carolina at the Texas 13-yard line. That was Chatham who went in motion. Pass incomplete at the five. The intended receiver was Mike Chatham.
Same play as before, coming out and throwing a little pass to the halfback. That time was just overthrown.
Now Delbert Powell, number 39, will come in with a play selection as North Carolina is faced with a third and goal at the Texas 13. North Carolina leading Texas 16-7. Wide to the right is Vic Harrison. That's Powell in motion. Bryant breaking tackles. He is one determined runner.
He's a strong runner. He was excellent footwork and leg drive by Bryant. Again, the same pass, so this time sort of into the the flanker and to the man in motion as we see the half, the quarterback coming out. There's a pass to Bryant. Watch the leg drive on him as he maintains his balance, keeps the legs moving, and continues to get power on down to about the 2-yard line.
The ball is spotted just short of the one. It is fourth and goal, and North Carolina asks for a timeout. Bryant was injured on the play. There he is. Kelvin Bryant, he is only a sophomore from Tarboro, North Carolina. North Carolina, fourth and goal at the Texas one. Lawrence does not get in. Texas holds. Texas takes over. Inside the Texas 1-yard line. No way you can credit any one tackler with that play, John.
Oh, that was a mass of humanity in there. The whole wall of Texas fell in on Lawrence that time. He tried to go over top into the end zone, was not able to make it. Let's take a look at it. There's the search by the defensive football team of the Texas Longhorns. Lawrence does not make the first down, does not get into the end zone. And that could change the momentum around in favor of Texas, but they're certainly in a very, very tough spot with the ball resting on the 1-yard line.
11:33 left to play in the game. McIver is the quarterback. McIver keeps, gets a little bit of room out close to the 4.5 or 5-yard line. Pickup of 4 if they spot it at the 5. And checking in with the play selection is Carl Robinson.
They have to be very careful down here with the ball handling. Make sure everyone has it so they don't cause any fumbles. So far, Texas has lost 1 fumble out of 3, and North Carolina has had no turnovers whatsoever.
Fumble by Clark. Oh, I think Texas got it back just short of the 10-yard line. About the 9-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 2. Howard David.
That's the telephone numbers to call if you'd like to vote on whether or not there should be a national championship playoff. Thus far, 167,000 have voted yes, 15,000 have voted no. Gentlemen, we should be thinking about offensive and defensive players of the game. Jack Russell of Continental Airlines here, and he'll be making the presentation with us at the end of the game.
Texas, 3rd and 2 at the Texas 9. Clark is just across the 10. Forward progress is closer to the 10 than the 11. It is short of a first down by about 2 feet.
John Unitas, my wife is not here, and neither is yours, but Ray Scott's wife, Bonnie, has come to the game with him, which tells me that she doesn't trust him, but she doesn't want to be alone on New Year's 1.
I believe I'll just leave that one alone.
North Carolina's Greg Poole back for the expected punt. Goodson, a line drive kick. Good bounce. Pull back at the Carolina 41. And a run back of 4 yards. North Carolina has a 9-point edge. 9 minutes and 40 seconds left to play in the game. North Carolina 16, Texas 7. Carolina field goal by Jeff Hayes after Texas was unable to handle a punt. Looking forward to being at that golf tournament, the Women's International, Hilton Head, on the 3rd of May down in South Carolina. Moss Creek Plantation. 3rd and 7. Here goes Bryant. First down. All the way down to the Texas 41-yard line goes Kelvin Bryant.
Take a look from the end zones. We see Elkins going back, handing the draw off to Bryant. Some good picking of the hole by Bryant as he picks up some great yardage, some outstanding blocking by his offensive team. I don't think he can give credit enough to the offensive line, the job they've done in opening the holes up for both Lawrence and Bryant all the rest of the evening. There's a happy guy. A lot of stakes on that fella.
First down play. Fake the end around, and Elkins is brought down for a loss of about 4 yards by an alert Texas defense led by Ken Sims.
Kenny Sims has been all over the field for Texas this evening. He's agile and he's big.
For those of you who are seeing North Carolina for the first time, we should point out that Amos Lawrence and Kelvin Bryant, alternating at tailback during the regular season, gained over 2,200 yards between them. They've carried on their great running tonight. There goes Bryant, or there goes Amos Lawrence this time, and close to a first down at the Texas 34-yard line for North Carolina. Third down and just about three for a first down. And we're coming up to the midway point of the third quarter, and Mike Chatham brings in the play from the sidelines.
He certainly has watched Tony Dorsett's way of running, the way he picks that hole and did that little pirouette around people. He and Dorsett look awful much alike.
Smith is wide to the right. Powell moves to the right. Elkins. Complete to Powell down to the 15-yard line. Now, Elkins showed great confidence that time because he could have run for a first down easily.
He had plenty of room out there to run. Let's take a look at it, and while we're watching, watch how much room he does actually have out there to be able to run with the football. He elected to throw it in there very well, and very fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
First down easily.
He had plenty of room out there to run. Let's take a look at it. And while we're watching, watch how much room he does actually have out there to be able to run with the football. He elected to throw it in there very well. And very fortunate he was able to hold on to the football. Delbert Powell on the reception.
First down, North Carolina, Texas 15. Just over 7 minutes to play. Carolina leading 16-7. Chatham in motion. Penalty flag down. Incomplete pass at the 12-yard line to Chatham, but a penalty flag down. Howard David, a special guest, a special announcement.
Hey, you can't be, you know, you're one of either right or wrong. I mean, 50% is not bad. 175,000 have voted yes in our poll of should there be a college football championship playoff. Only 16,000 have voted no. We do thank every one of you for spending the 50 cents, making the calls, and participating in our poll. Raymond?
Very good. Illegal procedure. Did I see that signal, Vince Buckley? I think I did.
That's right. They must have had a movement in the line, or there must have been two people moving at the same time. It wasn't anything very obvious, but
legal
sure
procedure, offense, first down.
First and 15 at the Texas 20. The Longhorns desperately need the football.
There's a young man, looked like someone walked on his hand and his face at the same time.
Elkins has a receiver out to either side. Second man, Lawrence. Woo, as he met at the pass.
One knee.
Good play by linebacker Robin Sendline of Texas.
I think they caught him in the middle of his spin right there and didn't get it finished.
Loss almost 2 yards. Second down, 17 at the Texas 22-yard line. The clock is running. North Carolina now has gained 326 yards. Texas with 258. Elkins. Ball batted back to Elkins. Well, what do you know? Elkins, very fortunate.
That's what you call taking into your own hands, Raymond. If you can't get it downfield, you got to take it yourself. There you go. Let's take a look at it. The ball was blocked right there, knocked right back into Elkins' hand. It was very, very alert. And down the field he went, picking up a few yards.
Dewey Turner blocked that pass right back to Elkins.
That is the 1980 version of the Immaculate Reception.
Third down, 13 at the Texas 17-yard line. Only 5 minutes and 40 seconds left in the game. Tucker went in motion. Elkins keeping. He's out of bounds at the 12. It'll bring up a fourth down, and Jeff Hayes will try to add 3 points to the North Carolina lead. The holder will be substitute quarterback Scott Stankavage. It will be a field goal attempt of 29 yards. 5 minutes and 30 seconds left in the game. Wide to the left. Texas still has life with 5:25 left to play. Texas continues to trail by 9. Texas with Rick McIver at quarterback needs to go 80 yards for a score, trailing by 9. Pass complete. And spun around was Lawrence Sampleton after a gain of about 8. And I think he might have been spun around to such an extent he was confused as to what direction to go.
I think he was. He was almost knocked back to the line of scrimmage. Very good hit, good catch, and very good attention on the ball by Sampleton to be able to hold on to it with that type of hit.
Gain 7 yards, second and 3 at the Texas 27. The clock continues to run. Koenig to the left. McCloney to the left. Couldn't quite get the ball to Rodney Tate. He may have been screened by the left arm of one of the Carolina defenders, I think. Well, I'm not sure.
That ball looked like it was thrown right on the money. He may not have seen the football coming over top of the defender.
Are you surprised that that many people voted, Howard David?
No, I'm really not. And I'm not surprised at the outcome.
That ball was perfectly thrown.
Yeah.
I think he was concentrating on that line, the out-of-bounds marker, and didn't catch the football.
Third and 3. About a yard shy of a first down is Rodney Tate. It is going to be fourth down. I'd have to believe that Texas will go for it here with only 4 minutes and 24 seconds left. North Carolina leading 16-7. And Texas decides to talk things over. It will be fourth and 1 at the Texas 29-yard line. North Carolina led 6-0, fell behind 7-6, regained the lead, and has held that lead with 4:21 left. Texas has a fourth and about 1 at the Texas 29-yard line, 4:21 left to play in the game. First down for Texas to the Texas 32-yard line. Carrying straight ahead was Carl Robinson. As the Carolina players look on from the near sideline.
Play is brought in that time, and they had to maintain the control of the football. Can't score without it, and they're a few points behind.
Caney and McCloney are wide to the near side. Big, big play. Calvin Daniels, the junior linebacker for North Carolina.
Let's take a look at it. Here you see McIver fake to the fullback. Fullback does not get a block on Daniels, and he comes in, and McIver's down. Not much you can do on that when that linebacker comes shooting in there and the fullback is not set to pick him up.
Loss of 17 yards. Second down, 27, and the clock continues to run. 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the game. Dick Crum, the North Carolina head coach, has never lost a bowl game. Last year, you may recall, North Carolina defeated Michigan. A screen to tight end Sampleton. Gain gain of about 17 yards will bring up a third and about nine. Screen before was, Sammy Johnson made the tackle. The
screen was set up very, very well by MacIver as he faked back to his left side. He came around and flipped the ball out to Sappleton, who picked up some good yardage. Third down and 10.
Dick Crum looks on. Third and nine, Texas at the Texas 33-yard line. 2.5 minutes left in the game. McCloney goes in motion. Complete to his running back, Mike Luck, but short of a first down by about, maybe 4 yards, 5 yards. There is Kelvin Bryant, number 44, sophomore, Tarboro, North Carolina. He'll be around for a couple of more years to help North Carolina football.
16 carries thus far, 80 yards for Bryant and one touchdown.
Fourth down, four, Texas at the Texas 38, and North Carolina asks for a timeout. With the clock showing 2 minutes and 23 seconds left to play. We're at the Bluebonnet Bowl in Houston, Texas, as we send a happy new year your way. Freddie Akers looks on. The crowd at the Astrodome looks on. Fourth and five, Texas. This might be it. And North Carolina buries quarterback Rick MacIver. North Carolina's 9-point lead, for the moment at least, is protected. 2 minutes and 17 seconds left to play. North Carolina takes over at the Texas 28-yard line. And Harry Standback, the Rockingham, North Carolina senior, right there, number 94, led the defensive charge. I don't need to tell you that his teammates are a happy bunch here in Houston.
Harry Standback, he's played an outstanding game along with Taylor on the other outside linebacker.
Rod Elkins all the way at quarterback. This is Elkins to the 25, to the 22-yard line. Elkins, who has directed this very versatile North Carolina attack extremely well, and Elkins will be around for a couple of years. He's only a sophomore from Greensboro, North Carolina.
He throws the ball a lot better than the people give him credit for. He has not had any interceptions this evening, has thrown it well, and has directed this attack very, very well.
We're unable to identify that Texas player we got a look at a moment ago along the sidelines. This is second and four. And Elkins has a first down at the Texas 16-yard line with only a minute and a half left to play. North Carolina has now rolled up almost 350 yards in total offense. Texas with a total of 264.
That time Elkins had an opportunity to go out of bounds, but elected to stay in bounds to keep the clock running.
Howard David.
Oh, Raymond, we have Jack Russell with us, regional vice president for Continental Airlines.
Bluebonnet Bowl, and our congratulations to Tex Barton, the Bluebonnet Bowl committee, and certainly to Kim Bride for winning this very coveted most valuable player.
There he is, Kelvin Bryant, our MVP. Jack Russell, thank you for being with us.
Thank you very much, Howard.
For Texas, only 45 seconds remain as North Carolina's head coach, Dick Crum, keeps his postseason bowl coaching record intact. He has yet to coach a losing team in a postseason bowl. Last year led North Carolina to that big victory over Michigan. Now he sees his quarterback, Elkins, carry the ball inside the Texas 10-yard line. Might have stopped the clock if Elkins got it out of bounds with 26 seconds showing on the clock here at the Astrodome at the Texas, or just inside the Texas 10-yard line. There he is, quarterback Rod Elkins, and he's a good one.
He looked like he was trying to stay in bounds. I don't know if he got him out of bounds or not. The clock is stopped right now with 26 seconds to go, and he has done an outstanding job directing this North Carolina attack.
Third down, four, at the Texas 10 for North Carolina. It will be fourth and about two.
Raymond, we should remind our viewers to stop making the phone calls, all right? We ask you not to make any more phone calls. The final tally, 184,000 plus, for a playoff, 17,000 against over 200,000 callers. We thank you very much.
Thanks. Sports Information Director Rick Brewer, Fernando Jones, Ramsey, Texas, just named to that post 20 years ago. So thank you, Jones Ramsey. Thank you, Rick Brewer. The Bluebonnet Bowl is history. North Carolina, 16. Texas, 7.